Okay, so first step is to have the horse standing still and relaxing from tapping. So this is a trained horse, obviously. So wherever I tap, ho, as long as I say ho, he is going to stabilize and not move.
vertical.
Circle is shorter, he needs to keep the stride as long as possible, just a different direction. We're going to have this left front foot, front to the left of his body.
Good.
So two things are important in there, is that I can get it. So all of this work is helping the horse to achieve what I call cognitive obedience. That means he knows, he's obedient because he knows what his job is, and he's always paying attention to my signals. And he doesn't like to make mistakes, so when he goes wrong, he goes, oh, I shouldn't do that, and overreacts a little bit. But this is a very, what we call in French and in Portuguese, a very fine horse, meaning he's very sensitive to the slightest thing. You know, it's like the princess and the pea, a little bit. But he's generally calm. But when you turn it on, there's a whole lot of horse there. So he's been very good about that. And those are the work that we're going to show at WEG next week. Some of the work we're going to show at WEG. Now, I want to say I'm using the lunge line, the knee lines, and halters for my friend Dan James, because they work very well. There's no metal parts. There's nothing to break or hurt the horse if you get a bit of a sharp movement. And I'd be very happy with that. It might not be exactly the first lunge line I would use on an untrained horse that might, you know, have a couple of hard reactions. But this is actually long lines that I have, I'm using as a single line. There you go. So that's what we do, and if you get a chance to be at WEG, check the schedule and see if you can meet with us either in the demo arena, which I think is Arena 1, or find our booth at the Zeno booth, which is, I'm understanding, close to the Dover, but I'm sure there's a plan. See you there. Bye-bye.